And MoneyWatch, the next generation wireless network, is just around the corner. 5G wireless service is expecting a massive rollout come 2020. With an average of 11 connected devices per U.S. household, consumers are more eager now than ever for a faster and more reliable network. CNET senior producer Dan Patterson joins us now to talk more about the capabilities of 5G. So what are those capabilities, Dan?
All right, Vlad, think about the internet you use now on your phone, except better and faster. Now, I'm joking a little bit, but let's dial back to dial-up internet and just think about not just the slow speed of data access, but you were limited. There weren't awesome web apps like there are now because your web access was pretty slow. Then imagine what happened when you had fast, high-speed data. All of a sudden, the web exploded in the mid-2000s. That's the potential that we're looking at with 5G in the next 18 to 36 months.
Are all 5Gs created equal? Because I know, for example, when I'm on assignment or traveling in South Korea, my internet is heck of a lot faster than anything I ever experienced here in the United States, even though supposedly we're the world leader in everything.
Well, a number of different technologies make up what we call 5G. That's kind of branding around this millimeter wave technology, which is high capacity but really short. So you'll see that in, say, football stadiums or in high capacity urban areas like South Korea or here in New York City. The challenges happen when you get to rural places like where I spend a lot of time in South Dakota. But we will see this kind of blend of 4G and LTE technology that we have now, along with 5G technology. So there'll be a little bit of a bridge and this longer rollout for more rural locations.
So what is the Internet of Things and how does 5G affect it?
So the Internet of Things is wonderful jargon that is really confusing. What it really is connected everything. So think about your Alexa at home or the way your car used to not have a computer in it, but it does now. All of those cars will be communicating not just up with the cloud and then back down, but with each other. So vehicle to vehicle communication. What this should do is maybe speed up or make transportation and traffic flow more efficient and make those home devices not just one-off little computing platforms that are maybe novelties, but computing all around you, so peripheral computing. That means all the devices that we rely on will kind of be built into the world around us and connected with high capacity, high speed data.
So what kind of impacts can we expect 5G will have on entertainment, for example? How will I be able to watch and download my Baby Yoda memes?
Well, Vlad,
need those.
All of the
need those.
You with your Baby Yoda memes might still be congested. But
really?
Look, if you go to a football game, for example, or a concert where there are a ton of people packed in, I think all of us have experienced the slowdown that happens on our phone. The millimeter wave 5G technology should make entertainment, live entertainment, much less congested. But what you should see with, say, CBSN on your phone or other streaming media is not just what we have now, which is pretty good. It looks, you know, very nice on your phone. You will see high quality images streamed to you very rapidly. It's not just faster data, it's more data coming through those wireless pipes.
All right, love me some CBSN, but Baby Yoda. He's adorable. He's adorable.
Well, all of those memes will be in high resolution.
I said two Star Wars memes to people in this newsroom already today. So, you know, I'm not kidding around. Dan Patterson, always great to have you, my friend.
Good to see you.